Snow White is a lady of many firsts. First Disney princess, first English heroine in an animated feature, her voice was even on the first feature film soundtrack. Her songs are appealing, catchy, and poetic. The lyrics are delightful, and the melodies are charming. But who was responsible for supplying Snow White with these iconic songs? Let's find out. Frank Churchill was born on October 20th, 1901, in Rumford, Maine. He began his career playing piano in cinemas at the age of 15 in Ventura, California. After dropping out of the medical studies at UCLA to pursue a career in music, he became an accompanist at the Los Angeles radio station KNX in 1924. In 1930, he was hired by Walt Disney, following the departure of house composer Carl Stalling, and began composing music for the company's Silly Symphonies animated shorts. His first project for Disney was The Chain Gang in 1930. He also composed for The Clock Shop, 1931, and Santa's Workshop, 1932. But his most notable Silly Symphony came in 1933, with The Three Little Pigs. Churchill composed Who's Afraid of the Big Bad Wolf, with additional lyrics by Anne Ronald. The song struck a chord in the midst of the Great Depression and became the Disney Company's first hit, selling more than 39,000 copies of sheet music and inspiring numerous recordings. Churchill's success helped change the company's thinking about the way music was used in its cartoons, setting them on a road where popular songs became an important part of the overall business plan. Inspired by the film's success, Walt Disney entrusted Frank to compose music for his first feature-length animated motion picture, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, along with Larry Morey. Disney's stipulation was that, much like the Silly Symphonies, the songs were not simply to be showcased. They had to stem naturally from the characters or be integrated into the story. A total of 25 songs were written for the film, but only 5 found use in the final picture. Disney was insistent that the quality of the musical score match the visual splendor of his animation, and that the songs be singable, have memorable lyrics, and bear melodies that would resonate with the public for years to come. It is suffice to say that the Churchill-Morey composer team succeeded on all counts and created a superb masterwork of film score art. The melodies are beautiful and the 5 songs timeless. I'm wishing.
I'm wishing.
I'm wishing.
For the one I love to find me.
To find me.
Today.
Today.
Whistle while you work.
Just whistle while you work. Cheerfully together we can tidy up the place. So I'm a merry tune. It won't take long when there's a song to help you set the pace.
Hi ho.
Hi ho.
The yodeling song.
I'd like to dance and tap my feet, but they won't keep in rhythm. You see, I washed them both today, and I can't do nothing with them.
Ho hum, the tune is not the worst of me to think. It's a silly song for anyone to sing.
And lastly, the iconic and supremely romantic, Someday My Prince Will Come. Because of the success of Snow White, Churchill became supervisor of music at Disney, as well as helping write music for movies like The Adventures of Ichabod and Mr. Toad and Peter Pan when they were in production. He shared with Jack Lawrence credit for the deleted song, Never Smile at a Crocodile, from Peter Pan.
Never smile at a crocodile. No, you can't get friendly with a crocodile. Don't be taken in by his welcome grin. He's imagining how well you'd fit within his skin.
In 1942, Churchill moved from Peter Pan to Dumbo. He and fellow composer Oliver Wallace won an Oscar for co-writing the score, which included the bizarre Pink Elephants on Parade.
Look out, look out. They're walking around the bed on their head. Clippity-cloppity, parade. In braid, Pink Elephants on Parade.
He also shared an Oscar nomination with Ned Washington for the song Baby Mine. Churchill re-teamed with Larry Morey for 1942's acclaimed Bambi, which featured Little April Showers. Sadly, after completing work on Bambi, Frank Churchill, aged 40, committed suicide on May 14, 1942, at his ranch in Castaic, California. Although there is some speculation that Churchill's suicide was a result of negative discourse with Walt Disney regarding his latest scores for Bambi, it was most likely due to his deep depression and bout with heavy drinking after the deaths of two of his closest friends and fellow Disney orchestra members who had died earlier that year within a month of each other. Tall, slender, quiet and reserved, Frank worked from a mere idea, story sequence, or character to develop timeless, classic Disney songs. It's heart-wrenching that such a talented individual was taken away at such an early age. It's impossible not to wonder what impact he might have had if he had been able to lend his talent to the world for just a little longer. However, the work he did leave us with continues to fill audiences with joy, sorrow, and hope. Thank you for watching this episode of Dizographies. Click the thumbs up button below if you liked it, and if you want to be notified when the next episode comes out, consider subscribing. Comment below with characters you would like to see us cover. Further reading and references are linked in the description. We hope to see you in another Dizography.